Lidchot, Klipot, Esav, Velavan, Veshem. So it continues this Vayamen and says that the lifestyle, based on Rashi, of Yaakov till now was to struggle and fight against all of these outside tensions with Esav, with Lavan, with Shechem. And then he wants to transition to the word Vayeshev. He wants to go from the world of dealing with the outside to go back to the world of Shabbat and go back home. And so comes the second part of the Pasuk and says, Be'eretz Megurei Aviv. Why do you need to add Be'eretz Megurei Aviv? Why can't you just say, right, Be'eretz Kanan? Why do you need to add Be'eretz Megurei Aviv? And the idea was that he wanted to go back into the world of his Abba, into the world of this feeling of I don't need to struggle. So the beginning of our Parsha, the first Pasuk, is Yaakov Avinu wanting to go back home and being tired of struggling with outside. And immediately, what does it say? The story of Yosef. Meaning there was something that Hashem was trying to teach Yaakov, which his uniqueness was that he was ready for outside. And that he wanted to go back to Vayeshev, but Hashem didn't want him to. Hashem wanted him to teach Am Yisrael and the Jewish people that there's something to learn and embrace and gain from going into the world of Esav and Lavan and Shechem and the struggle of Yosef and the brothers. And so I think that we see here the same idea of Hanukkah, mi bachutz. The idea of Hanukkah is to understand that so often we run away from outside. And Yaakov in this Parsha wants to run away from outside. And the preparation of this Parsha into the story of Hanukkah is to realize that we need to stop being ignorant to the outside questions. If in the outside world people are dealing with the question of intermarriage, it's not anymore an outside question. It needs to become an inside question. If the world is dealing with the struggle of why to learn Gemara, it's not anymore an outside question. It's a question that we all need to be aware of. If people are dealing with what does it mean to have a relationship, that's not anymore an outside question. That is our question. If people are dealing with the responsibility to family and to dedication and to all these different things, that is not anymore an outside question. The outside is teaching us to redefine our inside world. So my bracha as we enter into this Shabbat and into Hanukkah is to not run away from the struggles of what the world is facing us, but to embrace the questions, to learn the questions, and to bring them back into our homes, to redefine our homes, not as places that run away from outside, but they're aware of the outside and therefore could affect the outside. Shabbat Shalom and Chag Sameach.